Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at how to use the zoom feature to zoom in on a part of your screen. So today I'm going to tell you about one of the many tips that I have in my new book, 101 Mac Tips. It's available starting today. Go to this URL to read more about it. So to zoom in on your screen, you want to go to System Preferences, Accessibility. It's one of the accessibility functions here, and click on Zoom. And you can enable it one of two ways or both. You can use the keyboard shortcuts Option Command 8 to turn it on, and then Option Command and then the plus and minus keys on the keyboard to zoom in and out. Or you can use a scroll gesture with the modified keys to zoom. Let's do both. So now I'll turn it on by Option Command 8, and you can see I zoom in. In order to zoom in more, I use Option Command and plus, Option Command and minus, or I can use Control key. You can see I've set it for Control key here, and then two fingers on my trackpad to zoom in and out really smoothly. So under More Options, we have the ability to have the screen move continuously with the pointer, which I think is a better way to do it. So we'll turn on Zoom here with Option Command 8. Now you can see as I move my cursor around, it's always basically showing me where my cursor is, as close as it can get to the middle of the screen. Obviously, as I get to the edge, it's not going to be able to center it that well. So I think this is a very natural way to view it. Also, notice under view options, you can set a minimum and maximum zoom if you wish, which is kind of a nice way to do it. So they're the basic functions there, and they've been around for quite a while in OS X. But there's some things that have appeared more recently that I think are even cooler. So go to Zoom Style and set a full screen to picture in picture. Now I'm going to do Option Command 8. You see I get this kind of rectangular magnifying glass that follows the cursor around. I think this is really interesting because it allows me to really focus on a certain part of the screen. It's very easy to turn on and off with Command Option 8. And in addition to that, I can still zoom in more and zoom out on it. So I like this ability. If I go into More Options here, you can see now that More Options has changed quite a bit. I can set the window position to be stationary, for instance. So I do Command Option 8, and now you can see it stays in the center of the screen. And I can click this button here called Adjust Size and Location. And now I can actually move it around. So I can put it in the bottom left-hand corner, for instance, and then I could kind of resize it by pulling in the edges. And now I have this cool magnifier here at the bottom left corner of the screen where probably I don't have much going on. So I could just work as normal, but if there's something I need to see a little clearer as I move my cursor over it, I can look at the bottom left and see it a little bit better. I can still zoom in more on it and zoom out. You have a lot of ability to do things with this, like for instance, you can do temporary zoom, which is to hold down the Control and Option key to zoom when needed. So let's do Command Option and 8. So now I've turned it off. Now if I just hold down the Control and Option key, it appears. And it only appears when I have those two keys held down. So I can just be going about my business doing something, and when I want to read something, I hold Command and Option down and the window appears there. I think that's extremely useful. You can also change the style of cursor to a crosshair. So now it's a regular cursor on the screen here, but it's a crosshair here inside of the magnified area. And I think this is really useful for graphic artists. For instance, if you wanted to work with pixels inside of a graphics app, turn off smooth images here. That's important to do if you're going to go down to the pixel level and go into a graphics app. Here's Acorn, and you can see now how I could clearly see the individual pixels that are there, and I can actually add them. It's tough because the cursor, it doesn't always seem to be exactly where it is. That seems to be consistent with what I'm seeing on the main part of the screen. So different apps are going to work differently, but at least I could see really well where the pixels are, where it's hard to see when it's a 1-to-1 ratio in the main part of the screen. So I think this works great if you need to focus on a part of the screen. Maybe you can't read something because it's too small, or if you want to do some pixel editing and graphics. But here's where it doesn't work great. You have to realize that it's just showing you the same pixels you see on the main part of your screen. It's just enlarging those pixels. It's not actually giving you more detail in there. So in a situation where you have a photo like this, it's a high-res photo, if you zoom in using this technique, you're not going to get anything more in the lower left there in that window than you are in the main image. It may be easier for your eyes to see, but it's not actually more detail. However, the photo does have more detail. So if I were to zoom in using previews zoom to actually zoom in on the photo itself, you could see I could much better read these license plates here now, and it's still reflecting the same exact thing at the bottom left as I'm seeing here, but there's more detail in the photos. Just got to realize that the zooming in is just zooming in on the pixels on your screen, not actually interpreting the pixels inside of a photo. You got to do that inside the app, like inside of Preview or inside of Photoshop or whatever it is. Then you can actually zoom in and enlarge the photo itself. So don't use it for that. Use it for the other reasons. There is one other style of zooming. You can go into more options and instead of stationary, do tile along edge. And it's like stationary except it's going to give you an entire edge to the screen. If you do adjust size and location for that, you actually can just expand this. You can take up half the screen zoomed and the other half of the screen normal. You can also drag to the other side of the screen or down below or up above. So you can put it on any edge that you want.